This is Josh with Mechanical Pros. On today's video, this is what we're going to go over, wire sizing for mini splits, particularly the communication wire, what to do and what not to do, and how to properly install the wire. So specifically today, what we're going to be talking about is the communication wiring side of the mini splits, what type of wire to use, and how to properly wire it. So here, what you can see is on our mini split, this is our outdoor unit. You can see there's two wiring terminal blocks. There's one for AC power, which is just L1 and L2, and ground. And then you have this one up here that says 1, 2, 3, and ground. The 1, 2, 3, and ground is your communication cable. And specifically what kind of cable that is what we call an SJ cable or an SO. Essentially, that's a stranded anywhere from 14 to 16 gauge wire, which will allow you to communicate your outdoor unit to your indoor unit. So some common mistakes that I see in the field are incorrect wire types and also terminating the wires on the wrong terminals. And what this will do is cause communication issues and the equipment will not work properly. What I mean by incorrect wiring types are if you're using like a Romex wire or speaker wire, like 18 gauge, something like that, that's not something we want to use. We want to utilize SJ cable, which is a pre-made cord, essentially, which you would use essentially on your dryer, which consists of four conductors, which is you have your red, white, black, and ground, all of which is a stranded cable, and it has to be stranded because of the DC communication on terminal number 3 specifically. So back to the communication wiring, we have these terminals again, 1, 2, 3, and ground. These are really, really useful for installation purposes as you can kind of use it as a template, right? So if you know that when you installed the wire, you've landed your red wire, white wire, and black wire in terminals 1, 2, and 3 specifically, you can then match that wire on the inside. Primarily why it's very important to match the wiring on the inside is this terminal number 3 is not line voltage. This is actually DC communication voltage, anywhere from 50 volts DC to 150 volts DC. And if we hook this up on the wrong wire, we can have a lot of problems, such as PCB failures, equipment just not working, etc. Your 1-2 wires are just line 1 and line 2, so that's going to be AC voltage. Each line is going to be 120 volts to ground. So essentially, we're just taking line voltage, passing it on terminal number 1 and 2 up to the indoor unit. So we can then power the indoor unit with our outdoor unit. The terminal number 3 is then how this is going to communicate. It's basically going to take from the controller whatever mode you put it in, whether it's on, off, heat, cool, dry mode, etc. It's going to communicate that from the indoor unit back to the outdoor unit and tell it what to do. So back to our indoor unit, you can see why exactly this is very, very important to remember what terminal, as far as numerically, we hooked up outside compared to our inside. Because if you look here closely, we have terminal 1, 2, and 3 and ground from right to left instead of normally left to right. So that is exactly why it's extremely important, and that's 95% of the calls, why isn't my mini split working that I get, is because most of the time, our number 1 and number 3 are not in the same order. So right now what we're going to talk about is something that I experience in the field a lot, and that is one, back to the wrong type of wire. So 9 times out of 10, if a mini split is not communicating, and let's say you have a pretty far run, about 90 feet away from the condenser to indoor unit, I'll see solid core wire, which is a no-no. It's definitely not going to work. It will definitely work on powering up the unit, but as far as communication goes, we like to use stranded cable because it utilizes DC voltage, and DC voltage travels on copper wire differently on solid core, where it will travel on the outside of the wire compared to when you have multiple strands. It's going to talk better, it's going to be faster. That's why we utilize stranded cable. Another big question that I get is, well, Josh, my mini split's 150 feet away from my indoor unit. Can I splice the wire if I had to? Absolutely not. So we cannot splice wire. We can't use wire nuts. It's just going to interrupt communication. Eventually, that wire nut's going to fail because we all know wire nuts are not sized to amp draw or current. their size to wire size. So utilizing a wire nut, that's going to basically interrupt the communication. You're going to have in and out, comms, failures, multiple trips from technicians, and eventually the equipment will just stop working in general. So a brief overview of what we went over in this topic was the wire sizing. We're always going to go based on the manufacturer's specifications. Don't ever use wire nuts or solid core wire. And always, always, always remember your orientation is backwards on the indoor unit compared to the outdoor unit. Thanks for watching Mechanical Pros. I hope this video was informative, and we'll see you on the next one.